Hey Jackal fans, we are here with Tony Caldwell, Jackals catcher, as we are here doing another Jackals player profile on Jackals YouTube as well as KNMLeague.tv. Tony, how you been doing?
Doing good.
All right. You've been having a really good season so far this year, especially the last few days when red hot with the bat. Just talk to me about what you've been able to do this year. What have you been changing up this season?
Trying to make adjustments on the fly, not continuing to do the same thing and get out. But offensively, just been working with Jared and Ani, trying to make it simplify things, and try to barrel balls up.
Yesterday, you had your first triple as a Jackal, and you also had a home run as well, the left fielder, third of the year. Just tell me, what was that like about that triple? Were you thinking triple all the way on that play?
Yeah, and you're always thinking the extra base. I mean, that's just the way I've been taught the game of baseball. But it was unreal, I guess, a real experience because my father was here to see it.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk a little bit about you. I know you went to Auburn University. Tell us a little bit more, for those who maybe don't know who Tony Caldwell is, tell us about your time at Auburn and your catching career there for the Tigers.
I enjoyed playing baseball at Auburn. It was probably the smartest thing for me to do out of high school. I enjoyed every aspect of it, getting to play with the players I did, still communicating with them, staying good friends. It's just a brotherhood, and I really enjoyed my time there.
Tell us more about yourself. Where are you from? Who is Tony Caldwell outside of baseball?
I'm from Winter Springs, Florida. I enjoy the outdoors a lot. Enjoy the game of baseball. In the off season, I like to coach. I try to help out, give lessons, and teach kids that try to get them on the same path to play, a long career.
Shortly after your time at Auburn University, you were drafted by the Miami Marlins. I know it's a short experience for you. But, what is that experience like for a baseball player to get that call that you're going to get drafted?
Well, college, got me ready for that opportunity. And I was very blessed that the Marlins gave me the opportunity to play for them. And, it's just, one of those things along my journey that I really, took the good and the bad from it.
You've now been here for now two full seasons. Last year, we were here with this ball club. You caught a very good staff, Isaac Pavlik, Michael Antonini. Now this year, you're catching another good staff. We have like five starters who can go out there and shut it down every single night. So what has that been like for you to now catch two straight years here at the Jackals with these pitchers?
It's been a lot of fun. I just try to do my job back there, try to keep the pitchers satisfied, let them know, I got their backs, and I want the best for them every night. They go out there. Expect to win is our motto, and I want them to do the best that they can.
What's really key for you? Let's say you have a pitcher who's struggling. What's the key for you to try to get them relaxed?
Each guy's differently. I have to work with the different personalities on the staff. I pick and choose which guys I kind of get a little more aggressive with and then which ones I back off. And try to settle them down, try to get them going. Our goal is to establish a fastball as the starters and then get their other pitches working and keep them down in the zone.
Just tell me a little bit more about, your time here with the Jackals. Getting the first call from Joe Calfagate, what's it been like to work for him for the last couple of summers?
It's been a blessing. I really love Joe, and he's a great manager. He always puts a good team on the field, and I really enjoy being around him.
Which coach through your lifetime, who's really helped you? Is it your father? Is it maybe one of your coaches in high school?
I would say my father. I've had a lot of great coaches throughout my career, I thank them all for that because they, but it all started with my father getting me out there when I was 4 years old and teaching me the game of baseball and really teaching me what, work ethic, determination, and what it takes to play at a high level.
And, how has your seeing your father here this week, what has that been for you? It seems like every year he's here to see you work, and it seems whenever he comes here, you play your best.
Yeah, I mean, it's always amazing to put together three great games when he was watching with his eyes in the stands. It's takes a lot of pressure off my shoulders, and I just feel very happy that, he got to watch me play well and have some success. Baseball is a game of failure, and mm-hmm. you're not going to get a hit every game, and just the timing was, perfect.
Mm-hmm. All right, next up, folks, it's our rapid-fire questions. Rapid fire. Favorite movie?
Favorite movie, I'll go with Varsity Blues.
Favorite TV show?
Breaking Bad.
Favorite vacation spot?
I'll say probably the beach.
Which beach?
I'll say Daytona Beach, right where my dad lives.
Favorite animal?
I'd say white-tailed deer.
Okay. Favorite hobby outside of baseball?
Hunting.
Three players, MLB players that is, major league players that you would like to have dinner with, past or present?
I'd say Yogi Berra, Johnny Bench, and Ivan Rodriguez.
Okay. What's the best pitcher that you ever faced?
Best pitcher I ever faced? I would have to go with Sean Sanford.
Wow. And I guess I'd have to ask the question, who has the best beard then? I guess it would be Sean Sanford. Or is it you? Best beard. Who would it be?
No. Sanford has the best beard. I usually go clean shaven. I just...
That's your best favorite baseball moment growing up. What's your favorite one?
Favorite one was 2010 Auburn University and Creed Simpson's home run versus Clemson in the college regional.
Mm-hmm. What happened in that regional? How did it go?
We lost in the final game, but Creed, it was the game to get to the championship, and Creed Simpson pitch hit in the ninth inning, hit the 3-run blast to go up versus Clemson, and we won that game to get to the championship. We just fell a little short.
Mm-hmm. And what are you looking forward to most as we come down the stretch here in 2015?
I want to win the championship this year.
All right, folks, there it is. That's Tony Caldwell. Thanks, man.
Thank you.